Generally speaking, there are four important ingredients to any information visualization: visual cues, coordinate systems, scale and data types, and context. Let's use this line chart, which shows total home runs by year in Major League Baseball, to showcase each of these ingredients. So the first ingredient was visual cues, or visual encoding. This is encoding data with shapes, colors, and sizes. For example, if we look at this chart, we can show that each point shows the number of home runs in a given year. And we can also see that the lines connecting the points give us some sense of the rate of change of number of home runs hit from year to year. There are also coordinate systems, so we need to place our data points somewhere on the chart. A coordinate system gives us a structured space that dictates where the shapes and colors should go. This gives meaning to an XY coordinate on this chart. For example, in this particular graphic, the x-axis represents time, and the y-axis represents total number of home runs hit. Whereas the coordinate system tells us what various dimensions of our visualization may correspond to, the scale or data type will tell you where exactly your data needs to go. There are three types of scales that we could use: numeric, categorical, and time series. In this example, we're using numerical data on the y-axis, the total number of home runs, and we have time on the x-axis, the year. Note that both of them are a linear scale, so numbers are evenly spaced out. There are other types of scales, which we'll discuss later. And the final important ingredient of an information visualization is context. So if your audience is unfamiliar with the data, it's your job to clarify what values in your graphic represent and explain to people how they should read your chart. So in this particular visualization, I've provided some context by giving the chart a title, number of MLB home runs by year, labeling the axes, year, and total home runs, and I could do a little bit more by annotating the chart potentially. So there are a variety of things that might inform the total number of home runs hit in a particular year. Maybe the beginning of the live ball era, which we might put somewhere over here. The crackdown on steroid use, which happened somewhere around the year 2000, etc. These annotations might help people interpret this data and understand the story of why the number of home runs hit by year is changing over time. It's important to emphasize that data is the driving force behind all four of these ingredients.